again, good afternoon from my side. My name is Olli Castrén. I'm the head of Economic Analysis and Impact Assessment Unit at the EBA. And I have the pleasure to open this ninth EBA research workshop, which is an annual event which aims at bringing together economists and researchers from supervisory authorities and central banks, as well as leading academics every year to discuss how the banking sector is evolving and which are the challenges for banks and for the regulators. So for last year, we had a two-day very popular event on stress testing. This year, we are moving to a little bit different area. So the topic of the workshop of 2020 is new technologies in the banking sector, impacts, risks, and opportunities. And quite timely for the topic of the event as well, we are also doing this for the first time now as 100% virtual event. So technology is playing an important role also in the practical matters in our conference this year. I would just like to mention on this slide, so hopefully everybody has been able to take note of the key housekeeping issues. Please keep yourself muted when you are not talking. And you can also switch off your cameras in order to improve perhaps your own connection. In case you have problems with your video link connection, in the invitation that you have received, there is also a phone link available. So don't panic if your video link breaks down or if there are other problems in your connection. You can always dial in using the phone link and the instructions that were included in your invitation email. So with that, I would like to move on to our first items on the agenda. So I'm very happy to invite José Manuel Campa, the EBA chairperson, to provide the welcome speech to the event. So, José Manuel, please, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Olli. Good afternoon. Can you hear me okay?
Good. Yes, very well.
Very good. Thank you. First of all, good afternoon to everybody. Like Olli, I would like to welcome you to our ninth EBA Policy Research Workshop. As Olli said, and I'd like to highlight, these are annual events are very important to us. They are intended to bring together policy economists and researchers from supervisory authorities, from the world of central banks, from academics, to discuss salient issues in the banking sector and challenges from a regulatory and supervisory perspective, which obviously is our main sort of interest. These workshops have always been very good for us. They have generated rich discussions and have provided us with valuable input for our work going forward. I am happy to see that we have adapted to the times appropriately and that we can run this workshop in a digital format, and I hope it will go very smoothly. At least I know there's been a lot of preparation that has gone into it, and I really look forward to the 2 days. As Olli said, this year the workshop focuses on the application of new technologies in the banking sector and the impact that these technologies have in the sector, as well as obviously the opportunities and risks. I think this is very timely. First, because we're witnessing a significant increase in experimentation and rollout of new technologies across the EU financial sector. And this trend has accelerated, obviously, in the context of the COVID-19 crisis. But second, also, because I think that we're only at the cusp of what would be a period of immense technology-enabled change, not only in terms of the way in which consumers access and engage financial services, but also in the structure and functioning of the financial sector overall. Indeed, it is for these reasons that FinTech is one of the EBA's areas of strategic policy work in 2020 and for the coming years. Now, let me reflect a little bit on these points. Banks and other financial sector participants are increasingly leveraging new technologies to change and enhance the way in which customers access financial services. financial institutions have for some time been investing in mobile and online banking platforms and new systems for remote customer onboarding. Both of these things have been leveraged throughout the COVID-19 crisis as customers across the EU have increasingly turned to digital solutions to access their financial services they need. Now, in terms of operations and processes, financial institutions are also leveraging technologies such as artificial intelligence, cloud, RegTech solutions to streamline systems and generate cost services. We also see distributed ledger technologies and digital tokens increasingly being used across the sector in a large number of different contexts. Importantly, innovative technologies are also being engaged to facilitate new business models. You know, on the one hand, they are enabling further disintermediation of financial services by supporting the entry of new firms in the banking and payment sectors. On the other, they're also enabling the reaggregation of financial sectors services through the use of digital platforms, bringing traditional financial market participants to work together, and also potentially for new large players such as the big techs. Now, I know Caroline Rogers, who comes right after me, will provide her perspectives on the opportunities and risks presented, so I will not elaborate on these issues. Instead, I would like to use the minutes left to draw your attention to some of the ABA activities in this area. First, you know, I'd like to point out the ABA's FinTech Knowledge Hub, which has been established to bring together competent authorities in a common setting to enhance the engagement with incumbent and new entrant institutions and other FinTech firms about innovative technologies. The objectives of the hub are to enhance our financial innovation monitoring capacity and to promote knowledge sharing about opportunities and risks presented and to foster technological neutrality in regulatory and supervisory approaches. Now, why are these things important? I think that we need to keep pace with market developments to understand on a timely basis the opportunities and risks arising from innovative technologies. The example of this workshop today and tomorrow will help us keep in press in that pace, keep pace with that, those developments. And also, you know, we want to be able to respond with changes to our regulatory supervisory approaches as the environment also changes. Second, we need to promote a common approach across the EU to the acceptance, regulation, and supervision of applications of innovative technologies. This is vital when we think that incumbents seeking to use the same RegTech solution across a group, across the union, or for firms seeking to scale up their products or services across borders within the EU. Now, for many firms, we need not only common standards at the EU level, but also at the global level. You know, and here, the EBA's proactive engagement in international fora is fundamental on these FinTech issues. And I'd like to highlight, obviously, our engagement with the Basel Committee on Banking Supervision, but also, for instance, with the Financial Action Task Force. Also, we need to find solutions that are forward-looking and meet our stated policy of achieving technological neutrality in regulatory and supervisory practice. And for that, we need to be up to date on developments. For us, technological neutrality is about achieving the right balance between facilitating innovation, scalability, and competition across the EU single market, while assuring that we continue to achieve the central regulatory objectives of consumer protection, prudential resilience, market integrity, and ultimately financial stability. Now, in simple terms, this should mean that the use of a specific technology should neither be preferred or prejudged from the regulatory point of view, that we should not inadvertently prevent the use of new technologies because our regulatory or supervisory approach is unsuited to its proper assessment or misunderstanding of what the technology is meant to do or how it does it, while at the same time, we should also recognize that by design, banks, which are our main focus of attention in our mandate, have a specific prudential regulatory treatment, and that should be preserved. But also at the same time, that activities presenting similar risks should be subject to similar regulation and supervision, especially when using new technology. Now, this technologically neutral approach to an activity must continue to exist and will continue to exist in parallel with the entities-based approach for prudential purposes to ensure that, you know, when a firm engages in combinations of activities or the aggregate risks, the results for that activity are proportionally regulated and supervised, in particularly, you know, from prudential perspective to take into account the impact of the business and financial stability. Now, to achieve these elements, we need a space, for enhanced dialogue between supervisors and industry on innovation-related issues, but also between supervisors, hence the establishment of this FinTech Knowledge Hub that I've been telling you about. The hub can be accessed via our website, where you can find thematic reports on topics such as the impact of FinTech on banks, payment institutions, e-money institutions, also on business models, on crypto assets, on big data, and advanced analytics, and announcing now forthcoming report that will be working on topics such as RegTech and SubTech and platformization. And you know, as you know, most of this work that we've been publishing there is the result of the EBA continuous monitor of the regulatory perimeter to determine if it remains appropriate in light of emerging activities. This work has also fed some of our work into recommendations to the EU Commission for possible regulatory enhancements in the EU regulatory framework. It also reflects in our monitoring activities the use cases of innovative technology in the financial sector and the adjustments needed to ensure proper risk management by institutions as they introduce those technologies in their activities. For instance, a recent work in relation to big data and advanced analytics, you know, identify key pillars necessary to support the rollout of advanced analytics, along with a set of elements of trust that should ensure proper risk management. As I mentioned before, the EBA is currently performing an analysis in the area of RegTech to better understand the ongoing activities in this area. The EBA, we are also seeking ways to facilitate the adoption and scale up of RegTech solutions across the EU, while acknowledging and looking to address the underlying risks that may arise from that use. You should expect a report from us on these points next year. Also next year, you know, we should come out with a report in another assessment that we're currently performing on the use of digital platforms for the provision of banking and payment services. The overall objective of this work is to assess whether existing approaches to regulation and supervision are technology neutral and remain fit for purpose. Of course, applications of new technologies are also challenging a traditional approach of industry-based regulation. Innovative technologies are inherently cross-sectional and can be leveraged by participants across the EU financial sector to unbundle or rebundle financial services. This means that we have to challenge of securing a dialogue not only cross-jurisdictional but also cross-sectoral to ensure consistency in our regulatory and supervisory response. This points us towards greater cross-disciplinary coordination, knowledge sharing, and collaboration in our work as we seek to adopt forward-looking responses taking into account prudential, financial stability, conduct of business, AML aspects, data protection, and also potentially competition considerations. That is also the reason why, in addition to the FinTech Hub that I told you about, we have established also with the other European supervisory authorities, EIOPA and ESMA, the European Forum for Innovative Facilitators. This forum provides a platform for supervisors to meet regularly, to share experience from engagement with firms through innovation facilitators, to share technological expertise, and to reach common views on the regulatory treatment of innovative products, services, and business models, overall boosting bilateral and multilateral coordination. We also work within the context of our joint committee to make sure that we have an integrated response where appropriate to issues of technological innovation. So to underline, continuous dialogue between industry, supervisors, regulators, and other stakeholders is essential if we are really to maximize the benefits of innovative technology applications in the EU financial sector and at the same time mitigate risks effectively. This brings me to the importance of events such as this one that we're holding today and tomorrow. We hope it is valuable to you all to share ideas away from the immediate pressing aims of policy and supervisory agency. And I assure you, we see it as key for us to reflect on the changes that are happening around us and what we need to do to prepare for the future. These events are immensely valuable in bringing together different perspectives and stimulating policy debate in different areas. And the area that the topic that we chose for today or tomorrow could not be any more important, you know, if financial innovation. So we have much work ahead and look forward to maintaining this continuous and vitally important dialogue on the use of innovative technologies in the EU financial sector with you guys so that we can work to achieve this crucial balance of facilitating the scaling up of technology-enabled financial services cross-border while ensuring effective risk mitigation. Let me conclude by thanking all of you who have contributed papers for this workshop, especially to our two keynote speakers, Caroline Roger and Markus Brunemeyer, and to the EBA colleagues, particularly the program committee led by Samuel da Rocha Lopez and Giovanni Giamello, for the excellent organization. I look forward for an interactive and lively discussion of the excellent papers which will be presented over the next 2 days. Thank you very much for your attention, and thank you especially for your active participation today and tomorrow. Have a good afternoon.